The group of evacuees aboard chartered Uganda Airlines plane arrived at Entebbe International Airport at 2:30 a.m. from Bahilda Airport in northern Ethiopia. The 211 evacuees were received by the senior presidential advisor on special operations, General Muhoozi Kainerugaba. The evacuation process follows the fighting in Sudan, which started on April 15th as a result of a power struggle within the country's military leadership. The clashes are between the regular army and the rapid support forces.
It happened on Sunday when the armed forces under the vice president attacked the palace to overthrow the government and also attacked the airport of Khartoum. From that day, the bombing have been everywhere in town. The government, in return, they used their army to bomb the camps of the vice president of the army, the forces which are under the vice president, and which are spread all over Khartoum.
According to Uganda's ambassador to Sudan, Dr. Rashid Yahya Semudu, despite the ongoing war in Sudan, Uganda has not registered any loss of lives.
I want to thank again our government for the care and support. Like I've told you, we made sure that we reached all the Ugandans, and before we started the evacuation process, we kept in touch with them, warning them where to go, where not to go, and I'm happy that not even a single Ugandan who is counted among that big number of people who have died so far in Khartoum in this war.
He added that they are working around the clock to rescue the over 50 Ugandans who are still trapped in the war-torn country.
And as I've told you, yes, that is the number we have, 300. But in case, because we know, we understand that though the majority of Ugandans live in Khartoum city, but we know there must be some other Ugandans in some other areas of the country, because Sudan is a very big country. In case we are in touch with the Ugandan community to make sure that they feed us with information in case there are any other Ugandans they know. But the effect so far has been in Khartoum and those areas which are surrounding Khartoum.
211 evacuees include students, business expatriates, children, and the Muslims who are on transit to Mecca. The Member of Parliament for Bulisa District, Nora Bigira, who also doubles as the chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee of Foreign Affairs, commended President Museveni and General Muhoozi Kainerugaba for the effort they have put in place to see that Ugandans are safely rescued from the war-torn country.
I want to appreciate the President of this country for the spirit of patriotism, and making sure that his nationals were able to be brought back home safely. We appreciate the defense forces at all levels. We do appreciate the head of mission and his staff for making sure that they mobilize the Ugandans who were in South Sudan, rather in Juba, in Khartoum, and making sure that everybody was brought on board. And the continued effort of the Minister of Foreign Affairs and the staff and all the agencies for making sure that our Ugandans have been mobilized. And we also want to appreciate General Muhoozi for making sure that he comes to receive these Ugandans. It's very refreshing, energizing, and it gives us a lot of joy. That's why we had to come, make sure that we wait for them to ensure that they are safe, to receive them, and for them to feel that now they are really home.
Relatedly, renewed fighting erupted in Khartoum as the Sudanese army pounded paramilitaries with airstrikes today, while deadly fighting flared in Darfur. This as the clock ticked down on a fragile US-brokered ceasefire on its final full day. Ahead of the expiry of a three-day truce at midnight, the army said yesterday it had agreed extending the truce at the beginning of East African Regional Bloc, IGAD. There have been multiple truce efforts since fighting broke out on April 15th between Sudanese regular army, led by General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan, and the paramilitary rapid forces commanded by his deputy who turned rival. Unfortunately, all these have failed. At least 512 people have been killed and 4,193 wounded in the fighting, although the real death toll is likely much higher. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.